this newspaper.
We need to put a...
Yeah. Intermission.
My cool.
What the heck did you do that for? Why did you do that?
Yeah. Intermission.
We'll try it one more time. Don't slow down. Just keep going. Excellent. And we're going.
Oh! Oh! Frick.
We're recording.
Are you recording?
Yes.
Tim's big shoulder in the way.
Ah! Did you get that on camera?
We all knew at the end of the first film that Dangerzone 2 was inevitable. It would definitely happen sooner or later. And it just picks up right where the first one left off. And it's bigger, it's louder, it's more powerful. I think the other actors really work together. We've got a very quality film here, and I think people are going to love it.
My character throughout the two movies was a kind of a rich business tycoon that goes bad, and he's got kind of a dark side to him.
I play the crime rear boss, the Don Bowers is crime boss guy.
Basically, he's just in it for the money in the first one, and he's pretty lighthearted, and you can tell he really enjoys hurting. And which, you know, it was not a big stretch for me because personally, I like doing that too.
I'm the only one that could fill in the old guy part and be a bad old guy at that.
He is grown a lot meaner in this one, which, you know, no one really knows, you know, what the big jump and, you know, how he stepped it up a level in his meanness.
When I was doing research for my character, it was fascinating. The different aspects that he was able to put forth himself in this film.
All I heard from the first movie was that I wore these nice looking shoes, and that everybody kind of made fun of that. But I thought that was just another small detail in helping me as an actor kind of fit into my role just a little bit better.
I knew right off the bat it would be a huge undertaking. I knew there would be greater expectations. People would be expecting more.
I was excited. I was really excited about the team I was going to be working with and the director I was going to be working under.
The director, the Cove man, as we call him on the set, needed a more mature person for the sequel here.
This has taken the Danger Zone franchise to that new level.
Basically, I did in the first one, what I get to do in this one is just, you know, kick Tim around.
The stunt work in this video, I was looking to try and tailor the choreography, the fight scenes that each character had, tailor it to that specific person.
Yes, we did our own stunts. There was
there were times when Danny Covey, being the director, he would just come up with ideas and you think, boy, I don't know if I could do that. But he really, really took the time to sit down with you and work through the sequences to fit you personally.
We did all of our own stunts. Since I play a older crime boss, my character, they take it easy on me, per se.
There was one part where there was a stack of papers a little bit too heavy for me to hand over to Steve, so we had somebody else hand that over. Other than that, I did everything.
All the action scenes in this movie reinforce character.
We let the more younger people in the movie take the big hits. I just sit back and watch.
This set, I have to be honest with you, it was like working with family.
Well, it was a good atmosphere as a whole.
To be honest with you, I felt a lot of hostility on the set, and a lot of I don't know if the other actors were perhaps intimidated at my previous acting experience.
Because I feel that Tim has a little bit of an ego problem. And everybody on this set agrees with that. I mean,
we did enjoy beating him up several days.
I didn't pull some of the punches that I let him have.
I just felt a lot of hostility toward me from the other actors.
Never say never.
I think that a lot of people would like to see that, and I would be one of those people.
You never know. I mean, it could be. I could get a call tomorrow from Danny and he'd say, hey, let's make a Dangerzone 3, and I'd be right there with him.
And if there is a D3, then there's nowhere to go but up.
We all enjoy working with him. We all enjoy his directing style.
He, he just outdoes himself.
And it's just an awesome privilege to get to work with a man of his directing and acting capabilities.
I mean, he's the cove.
That's just what makes him the man. He's the cove, you know?
What can you say? He's the cove. I mean, there's no way around it. The guy's good, and it's a pleasure to work with.